हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन द नाइन्थ क्लास चैप्टर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स पीपल एज रिसोर्स। पीपल एज रिसोर्स मीन्स द रियल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द कंट्री। पीपल बिकम रिसोर्स व्हेन दे गोट एजुकेशन, ट्रेनिंग एंड गुड हेल्थ। पीपल बिकम्स रिसोर्स बाय द नॉलेज, बाय द एफर्ट्स। So today we are doing worksheet number 1, very short questions from this chapter. See, first question, define tertiary sector and name any two tertiary activities. Students, you know that there are three activities, primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary sector relates to the agriculture sector, secondary sector relates to the manufacturing sectors, and tertiary sector relates to the service sector. So this answer is this sector gives service to the primary and secondary sectors. ये sector primary और secondary sector को services देता है, that's why it is called tertiary sector. For example, banking and communication. Now see, second question is, what is meant by secondary sector? Secondary sector means manufacturing sector. Name any two activities of this sector. The sector which transform primary goods into manufacturing goods. For example, you have converted the cotton into the cloth. You have converted the flour into biscuits. So this is the manufacturing. It comes in the secondary sector. Now see the third one. Define disguise unemployment. When labor is given less hours to work in a day than normally required. When the persons do not get the work, but they appear in a employment. They think that they are employed, but actually they are not employed. Next is, what is meant by physical capital formation? Physical means in form of machines and equipment. When investment is made in machines and equipment, it is called physical capital formation. Next is, define human capital formation. Here human means, as I told you earlier, in the form of education, in the form of training, and in the form of medical care. So when investment is made in human resources through education, training, and medical care, it becomes the human capital. Next one is, what are market activities? Market means which gives benefit, gives which are gainful. Those activities which help in earning income is called market activities. Next is non-market activities. Production of goods and services for self-consumption. When production is done for the self-consumption, for not for market, that is called non-market activities. For example, if a doctor treats his own child, that will come in non-market activities. But if a doctor treats a patient outside, this is called market activities. Next is, define organized sector. Organized sector means which works under rules and regulations, which have food security. Which are job security that are permanent, organized sector, which works under rules and regulation, which have job security, which works under the rules and regulation, that are called organized sector. What is meant by seasonal? As the word seasonal says, when there is work on the season, but other season they remain unemployed. For example, in agriculture, when there is time of sowing or harvesting, there is work. In other months, they remain idle. So unemployment is arising due to seasonal factors, that is sowing or harvesting. Next is, define universalization of education. Here meaning is that all would get the education. Provision of education to each citizen of the country. Desh ke sabhi नागरिकों को शिक्षा मिले. दिस इज कॉल्ड द यूनिवर्सलाइजेशन ऑफ एजुकेशन. सो इन दिस वे Today we have done 10 questions regarding people as resource. In the next video, we will take the next 10 questions. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.